It's been an especially nasty flu season. The numbers tell the story. At least 53 children have died. Nearly 15,000 people have been hospitalized since October. And this year, instead of the typical flu flare-ups regionally, the Centers for Disease Control reports the flu remains widespread in virtually every state. Now, while most people want to avoid people with the flu, researchers at the University of Maryland's School of Public Health are recruiting them. It's part of an experiment to better understand how the flu is spread. Students with the flu sit in a contraption called Gesundheit 2. It's the brainchild of Dr. Don Milton.
Part of the purpose of this was to see how much people contaminate the environment around them.
For 30 minutes, the students stick their heads into a cone and simply breathe. The samples are then collected and analyzed to see how much virus each student shed.
The big surprise was that people, even without coughing, were still shedding virus into the air. And I think it was pretty surprising how little sneezing we saw. 11 sneezes in 218 half-hour observations. So sneezing is not that big a deal in flu.
Dr. Milton hopes the Gesundheit Experiment, which then tracks the students' contact with roommates and friends, might one day lead to a universal vaccine. Among the health professionals who visited Gesundheit 2 is Dr. Anthony Fauci. He's the director of the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases at the National Institutes of Health. It's nice to have you with us.
Good to be with you.
So Gesundheit 2, which obviously is in an experimental phase right now, I mean, is that the kind of answer you're looking for, how flu spreads, in order to be able to fight flu better?
What the machine like the Gesundheit tells you that it actually can spread by aerosol. And aerosol means that in very fine particles that can go for multiple distances, not just the 2 or 3 feet. So what we've learned from that is that a person can go into a room and not necessarily sneeze on you to get you infected, which is worrisome.
Worse news. Yeah. Why is it so bad now? We mentioned 53 children have died. Infants obviously always at risk, elderly people always at higher risk. But what's happening that it's so virulent this go around?
There are two or three factors that sort of converge. The first is the nature of the virus itself. The dominant one this year is H3N2. And historically, whenever you have a dominant H3N2, it's not going to be a good season. So your vaccine development is constantly chasing after getting the right match. And unfortunately for us, this year, the match is not particularly good. So we're projecting, we originally thought at the end of the year, when you do all the compilations, that it's going to be about 30%. It likely is going to be less, I would imagine, closer to 20% if we're lucky. Having said that, it is always better to get vaccinated than not to get vaccinated, because even a modest degree of protection is better than no protection at all.
What's the advice that you give? I mean, is it to avoid crowds?
Right.
Is it to avoid, you know, obviously people at work coming in who are sick? That's a bad idea always.
The first one is to get vaccinated. That's the first thing. But once you do that, one of the things you can't avoid is that when you are in the peak of the season, the way we are right now, if you have a choice, it's not advisable to go to a place that's a big crowded room. Half the people are going to be sneezing and coughing. The other thing that's really important that you can do, and it doesn't necessarily interfere with where you go, is to wash your hands as often as you possibly can.
What about a universal vaccine? How close are we to that? Is that a reality or soon to be a reality?
Well, it is certainly feasible, and I'm cautiously optimistic that we're going to get there. And by a universal flu vaccine means that you make a vaccine that induces a response against that part of influenza that doesn't change from season to season, or even doesn't change when you get a pandemic. Influenza is very unique among viruses. Take measles. I got measles as a child. The measles that's in the vaccine that I vaccinated my children with is the same measles that I got infected with decades ago. It just doesn't change.
And that has like a 98%.
98 to 99% effective. Polio more than 95% effective. At best, the influenza vaccine on a really good season is about 60% effective, and at a bad season, it could be 10% or less. But I believe that if you get a vaccine that really works as a universal flu vaccine, you could vaccinate the entire world the way we did with smallpox.
When does it end? How long does flu season last?
Most public health officials are projecting that in the next couple of weeks, you're going to start to see it come down. But even though it's coming down, you still have several weeks under the curve of flu activity. So just because you've turned the corner doesn't mean you're out of the woods.
So we're in the middle of being not out of the woods.
Exactly.
Dr. Anthony Fauci, so nice to see you.
Good to be with you.
Thank you.